We've been checking in on our local lawmakers, and that includes Senator Claire McCaskill from Missouri, who is joining us right now. Thank you, McCaskill. We've been reading your tweets. You've been keeping everyone updated on this. Any news from Washington you can bring us about this?
Well, I really only know what I'm seeing in the reports on news and on my Twitter feed, but I did take a moment. When I come into the office building in the morning, there is always a Capitol Police officer at our entrance where people are screened to come in the building, and there were a number of them standing there when I walked in this morning. So I took a moment to go over and thank them and ask them about their fellow officers, and they indicated to me that the officers were going to be okay. That was the only information I have outside of what I'm seeing in the news was the information that these officers that are in the Hart Senate office building told me as I arrived to work this morning.
Senator McCaskill, is this is the annual baseball game that Congress is part of. Is this something that you've participated in the past, and do you know much about the game?
Well, this is an annual affair. We have two bipartisan baseball events a year. One is the game that is played, Republicans versus Democrats, and then there's another women's softball game that is also a bipartisan game that involves the press, and it's really one of the things that brings us together, and that's what this shooting should do. I am dismayed to see too many people on Twitter trying to take sides after this unspeakable evil. This should be a moment that should unite all of us. We should not be retreating to our partisan corners and trying to paint this with some kind of political overview. This should be about common decency and evil, and all of us uniting at this moment to come together and agree that this is a huge problem, and we've got to figure out going forward. We want to live in a free and open society, but there is a real problem when either we don't have the mental health capability or there is some kind of extreme ideology that's around that is getting people to think that somehow opening fire on a field full of congressional Republicans practicing for a bipartisan baseball game is somehow the order of the day.
Now, Senator, we know that the lawmakers have been practicing at this spot for a long time, for several weeks, and we've also been hearing that had the Capitol Police not been there like they were, this could have been so much worse. Can you talk to us about the differences in security detail when someone like the Majority Whip is there versus if it was just the rest of the lawmakers present?
Well, people are sometimes surprised when they see me at the grocery store and they see me at the gas station and they see me, at Schnucks and in Kansas, in St. Louis, where I'm just busy being a normal person. We typically don't have security details, unlike the governor. And this is an instance where, because one member of leadership was there, there was actually Capitol Police, there was a security detail with Representative Scalise, because he's a member of leadership. Leadership team are the only ones that typically have details that travel around with them here in the nation's capital.
Do you believe that made an incredible difference this morning?
Well, no question that these officers, as somebody who was the prosecutor there in Kansas City for many years and worked shoulder to shoulder with the bravest and most courageous men and women that you can possibly imagine, and that is the men and women who wear the uniform to protect us. And not surprising to me, these police officers were incredibly brave and courageous and did what they were trained to do, and that is to protect. And they're the ones that I think neutralized the situation so that we didn't have a massacre on that field this morning.
So once you found out the news, who's the first person you called or tried to reach out to?
Not surprising. I have a seven children, a blended family of seven children, and not surprisingly, I began hearing from my kids, making sure that I was okay. So the first conversations I had were with my children.
All right. Senator Claire McCaskill of Missouri, thank you so much for your time, and we will be checking back with you, and we appreciate your time this morning on this the sad shooting in the Washington, D.C. area.